Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children, we welcome you to our online teaching academy Ekalaiva. Yesterday we started our new lesson consumption analysis. We discussed about consumption and we also discussed about human wants. Today we are going to discuss about cardinal utility analysis. We are going to discuss about the law of diminishing marginal utility. H.H. Goossen, he was an Austrian economist. He was the first to formulate this law in economics in the year 1854. Therefore, this law is also known as Goossen's first law of consumption. This law is based on the characteristics of human wants. Yesterday we discussed about human wants. Wants are satiable. Satiable means wants can be met. Marshall states the law as the additional benefit which a person derives from a given increase of his stock of a thing. The thing which he already has diminishes after a certain point. It goes down after a certain point. Now we are going to discuss about the assumptions of this law. Utility can be measured by cardinal numbers. Cardinal numbers means it can be measured such as 1, 2, 3 and so on. Next one, the marginal utility of money of the consumer remains constant. Marginal utility means utility per unit of money. The marginal utility of money of the consumer remains constant means unchanged. Next one, the consumer should be a rational consumer and his aim is to attain maximum satisfaction with minimum expenditure. So the consumer should be an intelligent consumer, then he can decide and he can satisfy himself by attaining maximum satisfaction by spending less. With minimum expenditure means by spending less. Next one, the units of the commodity consumed must be reasonable. So whatever, how much he is paying, according to that the product which he is getting should be reasonable in price. Next one, the commodity consumed should be homogeneous. It should be similar or uniform in character, like weight, quality, taste, color and all. Next one, the consumption of goods must take place continuously at a given period of time. So the consumption of goods must be a continuous process. Next one, there should be no change in the taste, habits, preferences, fashions, income and character of the consumer during the process of consumption. So during consumption process, the consumer should be constant. He should not change his habits or he should not change his preferences, importance for certain products, and his income also should be constant during the process of consumption. Now explanation. The law of diminishing marginal utility states that if a consumer continues to consume more and more units of the same commodity, its marginal utility diminishes. For example, if it is a summer season, if you are going out and come in, if you find a glass of water, so you will be having that, you will be drinking that continuously until you satisfy. Until your thirst, isn't it? So after consuming certain glasses of water, there will be a situation where you don't need, you don't want to continue drinking water, isn't it? So if a consumer continues to consume more and more units of the same commodity, so automatically your thirst will diminish, isn't it? So this means that the more we have of a thing, the less is the satisfaction or utility that we derive from the additional unit of it. Now this can be explained with a simple example. Suppose a consumer wants to consume 7 apples one after another. So the utility which he gets from the first apple is 20. So when he consuming 1st apple, the utility which he gets is 20, and while taking 2nd apple, his utility was 30. But the utility from the 2nd apple will be less than that of the 1st apple. So for example, the utility is 35 here. Here the utility which he got in the 1st apple was 20. So 35 minus 20 is 15. So for the 1st apple, the utility was 20. For the 2nd apple, it was 15. So while he was taking 3rd apple, it was 45. Again, 45 minus 35, his utility decreases from into 10. So again, when he consumed 4th apple, it was 50. So 50 minus 45, 5. So his utility is decreasing, 20, 15, 10, 5, like that. So after consuming 5th apple, at one stage it becomes 0. At one stage it will go negative. So I told you about drinking water, isn't it? So after a certain level, you don't want to take water continuously, so it will go to negative. So in this graphical representation of this tabular column, you can see here we find that the total utility goes on increasing but at a diminishing rate, but its rate is diminishing. On the other hand, marginal utility, if you take, it goes on diminishing. It, you can see it is coming down. When marginal utility becomes 0, the total utility is maximum. So here you can see the maximum level. And when marginal utility becomes negative, the total utility diminishes. So here this curve is called TU, that is total utility, and this line is called marginal utility. Now we are going to discuss about the criticisms of this law. Utility cannot be measured numerically because utility is subjective. So when we are feeling hungry, we can't say that I am satisfied 2 or I am satisfied with 3. So we could not calculate, and it couldn't be measured numerically because it is subjective. Subjective means experience or personalized. This law is based on the unrealistic assumptions. So these assumptions were not real. Third one, this law is not applicable for indivisible commodities. Some commodities we couldn't divide that, so it is not applicable to such commodities. And there are exceptions to the law. So hobbies, we can't say that our hobbies will diminish. It will remain constant. For example, drunkards, mices. Mices means the person who will not spend the money, who will minimize the expenditure. Then music and poetry and reading habits. These are all some exceptions to the law. Now, importance of or application for the law of diminishing marginal utility. It is one of the fundamental laws of consumption. So, it has application in different fields of study, such as based on this only we are going to discuss about law of demand, elasticity of demand, consumer surplus, and the law of substitution. The finance minister taxes a more moneyed person more and a less moneyed person less. If the person is rich, if his income is high, automatically he has to pay more tax. If for poor persons, if the income is less, then according to that they have to pay the taxes. Next one, this law emphasizes an equitable, that is equal distribution of wealth. So marginal utility of money to the more moneyed is low. So hence redistribution of income from the rich to poor is justified. Adam Smith explains the famous diamond water paradox. So what is meant by diamond water paradox? Even though diamond is scarce, isn't it? It is in demand, but its utility is high and its price is high. Okay. Diamond is scarce, it's not sufficient resource. Here marginal utility is high. We have to spend more money. Its price is high, even though it is not very much needed, but it is not an essential one. On the other hand, if we take water, it is available in plenty, but its marginal utility is low and its price is also low, but it is very essential part in our life. So these are all the application of law of diminishing marginal utility. Okay children, today we discussed about the law of diminishing marginal utility. Tomorrow we will be discussing about the law of equi-marginal utility. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you children.